Now it's time for the bath. So you want to get your water adjusted to where it is a warm. You don't want it hot. You definitely don't want it cold. While that's warming up, you get your towel. And you are going to get your towel all set up. And have your little measuring cup to help as well. So that's nice and warm. I'm filling some water up in here. And if you have a little shower head, believe it or not, the massaging of it feels good. So you have some water going down in there. And you can literally be warming them to make sure they're not freaking out. If they're freaking out, go ahead and turn that water off. And you might have to adjust the water a little bit more like I just did because it's getting a little bit warmer. And put them into the sink. Now, when you get around to the head, you want to close the ear. You get around that ear, and then this ear, because you do not want water in the ear. And then around the face, just take your hands and just bring it, and then you bring their little neck up. Now they can go down into the water. Just make sure that you really have them saturated good with some water there. And then you're going to start their spa treatment. Now they love it because they get a body massage. And if they're getting a massage, they don't mind it. Think about it. If you're getting a massage, you'll sit there and just let anybody do whatever they want that you trust to massage you, of course. And you're just getting them all nice and lathered up there. And then just go ahead and put them back in the water. Make sure their head does not get it. Take your little measuring cup and get most of the soap out. And use your hand for around the face. Once you feel most of that soap gone and they did not mind the shower head, then that's how we're going to get the rest of the soap out. We'll go ahead and let that water out so it don't get too full. Because you do not want to feel any soap. Once again, making sure the ears are down. You do not want water in the ears. Bring their little head up to get up under their chin. Once again, the hands around the eyes. Now, this is where a lot of people make the mistake. They take this puppy and they flop it on a towel. But your puppy has so much water in it, you actually can be wringing some of it out to make less work with the towel and less stress for the pup. So once you do that, you're going to put the puppy at the end of your towel and quickly come and cover the top with the other end, because the first thing you want to do is you want to get this face and ears dry. The biggest reason puppies will shake is they are trying to clean their nose, their ears, and their eyes out. Just like we grab a towel to clean our eyes. Once you have that done, then you start with the body massage all over again, drying. The drier you can get your puppy with a towel, the less stress with blow drying. Now you see that she is almost dry. Now use the other end that you started with to finish. If it was a nice summer day and everything was warm, you could literally let your puppy just go at this point because they're really dry. But we're going to go ahead and blow dry to show you the proper way to blow dry. And also it gives them a little poop. Okay, so now it's time to blow dry. They sometimes like it on lower. I'm usually so busy, I go ahead and do it on high.
Good.
So you're just actually relaxing her. something you would do every day. You want to go in both directions. You can see she's so stressed from all that, she is wagging her tail. And then you want to go down. You can use either side of a brush. I do like this side the best always because I feel like it gets it a little bit better. And then, and she looks like she is dry in all aspects. Here. I just want to make sure that her eyes are good and clean underneath again. Thank you today for being our example of how to give a puppy bath. I hope this helps you.
Across the horizon to find you.